Hey guys, 2011 Hyundai Genesis 2.0 Turbo. I'm gonna show you guys how to replace the head gasket. Okay, first thing, we're gonna disconnect the battery and remove this bracket here. Okay, after removing the bracket, we're gonna remove this from the all this from the air, this one here, and this air hose is from the turbo. It's gonna be this one here and this one here. So let me remove that. Okay. Then we're gonna remove all these turbo hoses, the sensor hoses. I'm gonna remove these ones here. Okay. Now I'm gonna remove these hoses here. We're gonna remove the coils and all the wire cables and these vacuum hoses. Okay. Okay, as you can see, I already removed all the air hoses and the wire cables. Okay, then we're gonna remove this hose here, radiator hose. So for that, we're gonna drain the cooling. So we're gonna lift up the car and we're gonna drain the cooling. Okay, after removing the upper hose, then we're gonna remove all this coolant hose here. All this part here, we're gonna remove it so we can be doing room for, because we're gonna need a room to remove the intake, to take the bolt. Okay, after removing the cooler pipe, then we're gonna take out these two bolts that's holding the intake manifold in these brackets. So let me remove that. Okay, then we're gonna remove these two bolts here, and we're gonna remove the injectors. All the injectors line. Okay, as you can see, it's already loose, so let me remove that so we could take the intake bolts out. Okay. Okay, now we're gonna remove the intake bolt. It's gonna be like a five. It's one here, two, three, the bottom, four, and five. Okay. As you can see, I already removed all the bolts and the nut. As you can see, it's already loose. So now let me remove it. Okay, now we're gonna remove the power steering pump. So for that, we're gonna disconnect the pressure hose, and we're gonna remove the belt. Okay, the serpentine belt. We're gonna remove the belt. So let me do that. Okay. Now we're gonna remove the pressure hose and the return hose. Okay. Okay. Then we're gonna remove the power steering pump. We're gonna remove these two bolts here and one in the bottom here. Okay. Okay, as you can see, I already take the power steering pump. I just put it to the side here. Now we're gonna remove this bracket. We're gonna take out these two bolts here. Okay, after removing the power steering pump bracket, then we're gonna remove this heat cover from the manifold. Okay, now we're gonna remove all this nut from the exhaust manifold so we can remove it. Okay, as you can see, I already removed the exhaust manifold. I just put it to the side. Now we're gonna remove all these plugs here in the back and the heater hose. Okay, since I saw a leak here on these lines, the thermostat housing, and we're gonna replace the thermostat, I decided to take all this manifold and the turbo out. So we're gonna remove these cooling hoses to go to the turbo and the oil lines. Okay, so let me do that so we can remove the turbo and the manifold out. Okay, as you can see, I already removed the exhaust manifold. Okay, now we're gonna remove the cooling fans, the electric fan. We're gonna remove it. Okay, so first we're gonna disconnect this hose here. We're gonna remove these two bolts from the cooling reservoir. We're gonna remove the reservoir so we can take out the cooling fans. Okay, already removed the cooling fan. Okay, I removed the cooling fan because we're gonna need space here, because we're gonna have to remove all this part here. We're gonna have to remove all this, and we're gonna remove all these pulleys, water pump pulley, and the crank pulley. Okay? And then we're gonna remove the valve cover gasket. Okay, so to take this big nut from the crank pulley, we're gonna have to remove the radiator. Okay, after removing the radiator, we're gonna drain the oil, okay? The engine oil. Okay, we're gonna remove the crank pulley. Already removed the bolt. Okay, after removing the crank pulley, then we're gonna remove the valve cover. Okay, then we're gonna remove all these bolts from the timing cover. Okay, after removing the timing cover, then we're gonna mark the marks here, and we're gonna take these two 10mm bolts from the timing chain tensioner. We're gonna remove the tensioner. Okay, then we're gonna remove this guy here from the timing belt, and this one here, and then we're gonna remove the change. Okay, so let me do that. Okay, after removing the timing chain, Then we're gonna remove the caps. We're gonna take out these bolts here. So let me do that. Okay. After removing the caps, then we're gonna remove the head bolt. It's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's gonna be 10 total. Okay, so let me remove that. Okay, as you can see, I already removed the head. It's right here. Okay. So now we're gonna send it to the machine shop. And wait for it to put everything back together. Okay. As you can see, I already have the head back from the machine shop. Already surface. Already grind the bulbs. I'm gonna put the seals right now. So now we're gonna put the bulb seals. Okay, now we're gonna put the intake valves in place. Okay, after putting the intake valves in place, now we're gonna put the exhaust valves in place. Okay, after putting the valves in place, now we're gonna put the springs, the ball springs, and the locks. Okay. Okay, as you can see, I have already the head ready. Now we're gonna put the lifters. Okay. To put the lifters in place, we're gonna dip it in the oil. And put them in place. Okay? Okay, I have the head ready already. Now we're ready to clean all this. Everything here. Now we're gonna put the head gasket in place. Okay, as you can see, I already put the gasket in place. When I replace the gasket, I use the copper spray gasket, so I use that here. So now we're gonna start the head in place. Okay, as you can see, I already put the head in place. Now we're gonna put the bolt. Okay, I already put the bolt in place. Now we're gonna torque. We're gonna use the torque to torque the bolt. We're gonna do the 25 foot pounds first, and then 90 degrees. 90. Okay, after finish torquing all the bolts, then we're gonna put the cams. Okay, as you can see, already put the cams in place. Now we're gonna put the timing guides and the timing belt in place. Okay. So now we're gonna put the timing. I don't know if you guys be able to see it, but you see these different sprocks. It's 1, 2, and 3. So these 3 sprocks, we're gonna measure them on the dots, on the sprocks, and the cam and the cramped sprocks. So let me put this together. Okay guys, as you can see, I already put the time in. You see this dot here? You see the different spark? It's like a kind of darker. That's the way it's supposed to go. As you can see, this one here too. And the same thing on the crank. Okay. So that's the timing marks. Okay, after finishing the timing, then we're gonna make them at least 2 turns, so we could see everything is okay. Okay, so everything looks okay. So now we're gonna put the timing cover. Okay, as you can see, I already put the timing belt cover. So now we're gonna put the ball cover. Okay, already put the ball cover and tie everything. So now we're gonna put the intake manifold in place. Okay, as you can see, I already put the intake gasket in place. Now let me put the intake. Okay, now I'm gonna put a few injectors in place. Okay, after putting the few injectors, then we're gonna put this coolant pipe that goes in the back here. Okay, so let me do that. Okay, now after putting the pipe in the back, the coolant pipe, now we're gonna put this one here on the side. Before putting this pipe, don't forget to put the 2 bolts from the brackets that hold the intake that goes on the bottom. Okay, so let me put this in place. Okay, after connecting the coolant pipe here, this one here on the side, then we're gonna go on the back here and we're gonna connect the heater hoses and all these cooling hoses in the back here. Okay. Okay, after connecting the heater hoses, then we're gonna come in the front here and we're gonna connect this cooling hose here. Okay, so let me do that. Okay, then we're gonna put the crank pulley in place. Okay, as you can see, I already put it. Now I'm gonna put the bolt. And we're gonna tighten it, okay? Okay, after putting the crank pulley, then we're gonna put the belt tensioner. Okay, after putting the tensioner, then we're gonna put the 2 pulleys, the ones that go here. Okay, after putting the pulleys, then we're gonna put the thermostat housing. In this case, we're gonna replace the thermostat. Okay, after putting the thermostat housing, then we're gonna put the water pump pulley in place. Okay, after putting the water pump pulley, then we're gonna put the exhaust manifold gasket. Okay, So now we're gonna put the exhaust manifold and the turbo in place. Okay, after tie the bolts and the nuts from the manifold, then we're gonna put out these cooling hoses here, connect everything. Okay, after finishing with the exhaust manifold, then we're gonna put this power steering bracket here in place. Okay. Okay, now we're gonna put the power steering pump in place. Okay, so let me do that. Okay, then we're gonna put the power steering pressure hose. Okay, now we're gonna put the radiator. Okay, after putting the radiator, now we're gonna put the cooling fan. Okay, after putting the bottom hose and the transmission lines, then we're gonna put the drive belt in place. Drive belt. So let me do that. Okay, now we're gonna put the fuel line. Okay, after putting the fuel line, then we're gonna put the ignition coils. Okay, now we're gonna connect all the plugs, put all the harness, and connect all the plugs together. Okay, then we're gonna put this part here, the sensors. Okay. Now we're gonna put this coolant line here. Okay, now we're gonna put the manifold heat cover. Okay, then we're gonna install this air outlet from the turbo that goes on the air filter, and it goes here too. Okay, now we're gonna install the air filter and this part here. Okay, now we're gonna put in place this air pipe from the turbo. Then we put this air vacuum from the booster. Okay, now we're gonna put the engine cover here. Okay, now we're gonna put the coolant reservoir in place. Okay, after putting the coolant reservoir, then we're gonna put the engine oil. Okay, after putting the oil, now we're gonna put the coolant. Okay, after putting the coolant, then we're gonna put this bracket in place. Okay, then we're gonna put this part in place. Okay, after putting this in place, now we're gonna connect the battery. Okay, as you can see, I put everything all together. Now we're gonna start it so we can see how it's working. Okay, as you can see, I already have it on. It looks everything is working fine. So that's how to replace the head gasket on a Honda 2011 Honda Genesis 2.0 turbo. If you guys like the videos,
don't forget to subscribe. That's it, and thanks for watching.